In 1619, the first slaves from Africa came to America due to the Atlantic slave trade. Slaves didn't let captivity stop them from practicing their musical traditions. Men who captured slaves also brought some of their instruments with them so that slaves could stay limber throughout the transatlantic trip. During slavery, slaves would sing work songs while picking cotton. Work songs are songs slaves would sing to give themselves a good working rhythm to keep up the pace. One of the unique styles of music they used was the call and response. These songs could be considered early forms of blues. Blues music incorporated spirituals, work songs, field hollers, shouts, and chants. Early blues often took the form of a loose narrative, often relating to troubles experienced in the African American society. The blues formed in the late 19th century in the Deep South. The most common form of blues is 12-bar blues. 12-bar blues is a distinctive form in lyrics, phrases, chord structure, and duration. The most common structure is the AAB pattern, which consists of a line sung in the first four bars, then repeated in the next four bars, and then the last bars, a different line is sung. Some of the most famous blues singers are B.B. King. I love the way. W.C. Handy. A specific form of blues called boogie woogie blues was a piano style popularized in the 1930s and 1940s that featured repeated bass figures against a syncopated improvised melody. This form of blues evolved into R&B. R&B's lyrical theme often expressed their African-American pain and quest for freedom, but R&B is a broad genre. Is a gospel-influenced African-American popular music style that began to emerge in the late 1950s and became big in the 1960s. In addition to the gospel influence, soul music is a combination of R&B and jazz. Some of the most famous soul musicians are Ray Charles, Sam Cooke, Aretha Franklin, for me to love you. And James Brown and the Famous Flames. James Brown became the fan favorite of the Famous Flames. Eventually, he would become so famous that he left the band and created his own revolution. Funk music is an African-American popular music style. It features syncopate, interlocking rhythm, pattern, based on straight quaver and semi-quaver subdivision, a vocal style drawn from soul music, extended vamps based on a single and often complex harmony, strong emphasis on the bass line, and lyrics with frequent spiritual theme and social commentary. We can credit James Brown as the founder and the father of funk. James Brown's most famous funk songs are I Got You, I Feel Good, Papa Got a Brand New Bag, Make It Funky, my thing. Some of the most famous funk musicians are Earth, Wind, and Fire. George Clinton. Stevie Wonder, suffering from blindness from birth, was a child prodigy that didn't let his blindness hold him back. Stevie Wonder's funk song, Superstition, is one of the most famous funk songs ever produced. Stevie Wonder used his innovation of the clavinet to produce unique songs throughout his career. Funk music had its reign as a popular music genre, but even funk started to slow down. Funk music influenced creations of other popular genres. From funk came the dance music of disco, which contains a mixture of funk, soul, pop, and salsa. Another derivative of funk is hip-hop. Hip-hop developed by inner-city African-Americans in the 1970s, which consists of stylized rhythmic music and rapping. Now what you hear is not a test, I'm rapping to the beat. And me, the groove, and my friends are gonna try to move your feet. You see, I am Wonder Mike, and I like to say hello. Up to the black, to the white, the red, and the brown, the purple, and yellow. But first, I gotta bang, bang, the boogie to the boogie, say up. From the transatlantic slave trade to today's hip-hop rap music, African-American music will always be a significant part of American history. African-American music will continue to evolve through the ages, and all will listen to it in amusement.